Quran. MashaAllah. You don't get any award for that. Simple question. Simple answer. No one will disagree. He may not be a practicing Muslim, but if you ask any Muslim, which is the best book in Islam, the most authentic book, the best source for knowledge in Islam, the answer is Quran. MashaAllah. But nothing great. The second question, which is the next source of knowledge after the Quran? Hadith. MashaAllah. No two difference. Hadith of the Prophet Muhammad. You may say Sunnah, you may say Hadith. There is no two difference. Everyone agrees. Whichever type of Muslim he may be, he agrees the first main source is Quran, the next is Hadith. Now, most of us are aware that there are different types of Hadith. Some Hadith which are Sahih Hadith, which are strong, authentic. Some Hadith are Zaif Hadith, which are weak Hadith. Some of them are Maudu, concocted, fabricated Hadith. Which Hadith a Muslim should follow? Sahih Hadith. MashaAllah. Three questions, the answer remains the same. It will not differ. Any type of Muslim you ask, whichever group he may belong to, whichever sect he may belong to, the answer is the same. Number one source is Quran, Allah's Kalam, Allah's word. Number two source is the sayings of the Prophet, the Hadith, the narration of the Prophet. Number three, that in the Hadith, what we have to follow is the Sahih Hadith. No two view at all. Talawila kalmitin sawa imbarina bainakum. Come to common terms as been asked you. Now, based on these three answers, we proceed further. But when I ask a Muslim that what is he or what school of thought he belongs to or what is his madhab, most of the Indians, they tell me they are Hanafi. Some may say they are Shafi. If I go outside India and when I ask this question, besides Hanafi and Shafi, I may get the reply, I'm a Hanbali. Or some may say, I'm a Maliki. But in India, majority of the Muslims, they call themselves Hanafi. Some even call themselves Shafi. There are others, but these two are the major groups. I ask the next question. Brother, why are you a Hanafi? Why are you not a Shafi? So the common reply I get is, because my parents were Hanafi. My father was Hanafi, my mother was Hanafi, so I am a Hanafi. So then I ask him a question, what if your father was a Shafi? So he tells me, brother Zakir, if my father was a Shafi, even I would have been a Shafi. Answer is simple. I said, very good. Till here it is simple. What if your parents were non-Muslims? What would you be? Then there is a long pause. See, you told me if your parents, because your parents are Hanafi, you are a Hanafi. If your parents were Shafi, you would have been a Shafi. Very logical. What if your parents were non-Muslims? Then there is a long pause. I said, brother, why don't you reply? He replies in a very soft tone. Maybe I would have been a non-Muslim. Softly he says, maybe I would have been a non-Muslim. So I said, fine. Now if your age is 30 or 40 years, and now if you give me the reply that you are a non-Muslim, whether a Hindu or a Christian or a Jew or a Jain, you give me the reply, I am a non-Muslim because my father is a non-Muslim or my mother is a non-Muslim, will you be excused? There's a long pause. He doesn't reply. I said, if you say yes, then all the non-Muslims today, even they will be excused. Because most of the parents have been non-Muslims. So there's a long pause. Then he gives me the reply after thinking, if Allah gives me hidayah, I will become a Muslim. I said, fine. If Allah gives you the hidayah, you'll become Muslim. But Allah says in the Quran, in Surah An-Kabut, chapter number 29, verse number 69, that if you strive in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do jihad fi sabilillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open his pathways for you. The criteria is you should strive. If you strive, Allah will give you hidayah. It's a promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you strive in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will open up his pathways for you. So the criteria is that if you strive, Allah will open up the pathways. Like yesterday we saw, and in the past few days, we saw many non-Muslims coming and telling that, you know, I've been born in a non-Muslim family, what's my fault? And I told him, and many of you were there yesterday, and I proved to him that, fine, if you accept Islam now, all your past sins will be forgiven. So yet, you have a chance, and many non-Muslims have accepted Islam. So the criteria is that you should strive. So when you tell the non-Muslims that they should strive in order to find the haqq, if a non-Muslim comes and tells you that why are you a Muslim, and you give the reply, because my fathers are Muslim, so he will tell you, have you strived? Have you tried and found the truth? So it becomes your duty even to study about Islam. Read the Quran and the Hadith. Compulsory. If we tell the non-Muslims, we shouldn't include that to the Muslims, even you should strive for the haqq. Then I say, Alhamdulillah, your parents, mashallah, they have Hanafi Shafi belonging to Muslims, and my parents are Muslim, Alhamdulillah, therefore we are Muslims. Allah's grace, Alhamdulillah. Then I ask him the next question. That brother, you said you are a Hanafi. Which is better? Hanafi is better or Shafi is better? That's my next question. Which is better, Hanafi or Shafi? Most of these group of Muslims, they will give the reply, Ke charo musalle barhaq hai. All the four schools of thought are on the truth. That is a common reply. That all the four schools of thought, Hanafi, Maliki, Shafi, Hanbali, all of these four schools of thought, they are barhaq, they are correct. Some will say Hanafi is right, some will say Shafi is right, but the majority will say charo musalle barhaq hai. All the four schools of thought are correct. Then I ask another simple question. Now these questions are known to everyone, it's not a difficult question. Then ask the next question. Brother, in your musalla, in your maslak, in your madhab, in the Hanafi musalla, if a man is in wudu, and if accidentally he touches a woman, or a woman touches him, does he go outside the state of wudu, or is he yet in the state of wudu? In Urdu we say, wudu tootti hai kya nahi? Does the wudu break or not? In English, we will say, is he yet in the state of wudu or outside the state of wudu? So the Hanafi will reply that in the Hanafi madhab, the wudu does not break. I said, fine, let's go to the next question. In the Shafi madhab, in the Shafi musalla, if a man accidentally touches a woman, or a woman accidentally touches a man who is in a state of wudu, is he yet in the state of wudu or outside the state of wudu? Uski wudu tootti hai kya? Does his wudu break or not? The reply will be, mashallah. All of you know it. Simple question, simple answer. The wudu breaks. It's nothing difficult. All these questions so far are simple. In the Shafi musalla, the Shafi madhab, the wudu breaks. My next question, again very simple. I ask the question, dear brother, can both be simultaneously correct? That one Muslim's wudu breaks when it accidentally touches a woman, and the other Muslim's wudu doesn't.